Hey guys, Mitty here. This video will be a short review of the upcoming Archer class, or the Ascension form of it. As always, I will showcase the skills, maybe add some comments, share with you a few test results, and of course make the overall conclusion about the class itself. Archer is the first male ranged class. He uses a crossbow as his weapon and sometimes can even engage close combat with his fists and legs, if you really want some style points. Other than that, he's fast ranged damage dealer with good constant damage and average burst. Even though Archer's skills kit transforms him into a standing turret that doesn't move during combat, two escapes grant him good survivability and the dash instead of roll makes him slightly more mobile if compared to Huntress. Talking about which, Archer is very similar too, and most of his skills will be very familiar to player who mained or at least tried Huntress. And first skill is straight almost a clone of Huntress Blasting Gust. Briefly shoots a bolt that does average damage and dazes his opponents. Has branches, forecast, super armor infield, and can dash if used in combination with movement in any direction. Range is a bit lower than Huntress twin skill though. Second skill, after a brief charge, Archer discharges his crossbow like a shotgun, dealing damage in a cone, knocking down his opponents. Has branches, low cooldown, and super armor infield. Range is the same as the first skill. Third skill is similar to Huntress Spinning Shot, but does less damage and has no branches. Also, it's a combination of two shots, and only the final hit has knockback effect. Quite an useless skill, to be honest. Fourth skill briefly shots two combinations of volley in front of him, in wide cone, dealing reasonable damage. Has branches, two casts, but has no immunities or CC. Great skill for PvE farming or hardcore PvP damage filler. Fifth skill will be used always, everywhere and the most. I can even say that this skill describes the whole Archer idea. Channels a burst of multiple shots, up to 12, with his crossbow unleashing massive damage and knocking down his opponents. Has great and constant damage, branches, super armor in arena and healing effect. Also at level 3 has a perk that allows him to repeat the same burst of 12 shots once again, but this time without healing and super armor only in field. Similar to Huntress Razor Wind, but slightly stronger and much better in terms of CC and speed. Sixth skill is Archer's first melee and sort of glove closer skill. Reminds of the Striker's Kick, but frankly very useless. It has average damage and bond effect, but no immunity, no branches and 0 point of using it as a ranged class, neither PvP nor PvE. Seventh skill and second highest damage skill in Archer's kit, after a short charge, unleashes two bursts of bolts at an average range, has branches, knockdown effect and super armor infield. Mostly used in combination after 5th skill as a finisher, since it combines and increases the cast speed. 8th skill is Archer's second melee skill, also with small gap close and average damage, but this time with branches and range shot as last hit. The downside is again the fact of being melee skill, without any sort of immunity. Might be used in PvE due to Serret branch and fast cast, but never in PvP. 9th Archer skill is his first mobility and escape skill, with full invulnerability in Arena 2, and backward or any directional jump with a swift stun shot that dazes the opponent's hit. Which in this case is even better in somewhat than Huntress explosive shot. The downside of it has only one use and only one jump, so it's 4 times worse than Huntress skill in terms of survivability, so must be used wise. 11th skill is his second mobility and escape skill, but this time has super armor in Arena 2. Jumps in the air, performing long range jump, bombarding and bonding his enemies with his crossbow. The damage is good, but has no branches, very long cooldown and only one use, so just like with the 9th skill, must be used wise. The buff is quite simple, no extra effects, HP regen, AP buff and dodge ability decrease cooldown. Can say the skill set has something special, and I don't think Archer can shine in current meta, but it's something that is yet to be tested in real time tomorrow. Moving on to the tests, in Alien PvE, Archer was able to reach 160 kills per minute, but since I have around 300 ping on Korea, this number should be higher. I'd bet for 180 kills per minute, slightly more than Archmage, but you never know. In Hadoom, which was even more affected by ping, the result was only 280 kills per minute, but on Global the real number should be around 350 or even more. As for DPS, Archer showed an average result of 11,437% damage in 5 seconds burst, including branch damage and their average effects damage. This test is new for my channel, but I received good results after testing all the classes. I'll post the full test results later on in one of my next top list videos. But just so you understand what this number means, I can just share with you as a reference three other classes test. The lowest one, Destroyer, with only 7573% damage. Huntress, as an Archer's sister and comparison, with only 9113% damage. And the highest one, Nova, with an outstanding 17,821% damage score. Amazing, right? Sadly, I didn't have possibility to test Archer in Mass PvP or Ramones, but looking at the skills, I can say that Archer will be better than Huntress for sure, but will still struggle in some modes. As for Arena PvP, less survivability, but more damage and higher catching ability than Huntress. One thing I like about him is his 5th skill, that has ability to knock down opponents with any of the 12 hits, and not only last one, thus giving him better CC potential against some classes. Overall, Archer is worth trying, but as was mentioned already, he doesn't really fit the current meta in-game. And that was it for the Ascended Archer form overview. In next video, I will review the Awakening one, Fletcher, and we'll compare the bot forms to choose the best one of the two. Next, we'll follow builds and some PvP matches from Korea. Don't forget to leave a like, comment and subscribe. And of course, enjoy! Falling in more times than I can get out.